In part one, Thomas automated his cross-currency liquidity workflow in partnership with his bank. This enabled him to efficiently pool excess liquidity into euros, where his funding needs were greatest. It also freed him up to focus on other priorities, because he no longer needed to constantly monitor his balances across multiple currencies. However, there are still occasional large cash flows that result in unexpected overdraft costs or negative interest charges. They need manual intervention and require Thomas to keep larger target balances than he would like. These cash flows are the result of FX hedges. Thomas's company uses FX hedges to limit their exposure to fluctuations in exchange rates. For instance, Thomas's company executes an FX hedge to align their revenue and costs. On one order, they will receive US dollars, but costs are in euros. The hedge will protect their profits from adverse FX moves. Thomas's problem comes when a hedge settles into cash, especially if the payment is delayed, but the hedge is not rolled. Thomas contacts Sarah, who manages the company's FX hedging program. Sarah explains that she has access to large volumes of data, which she uses to calculate FX exposures and hedge them. She has built a spreadsheet tool to refine the raw data into exposure information. She then combines this with cash account balances to determine the appropriate FX hedge, which is traded through an execution platform. Occasionally, the hedges settle into cash, which doesn't impact FX risk, but it does impact cash positions, leading to the large cash flows that are causing Thomas problems. Sarah's process is effective but time-consuming and requires manual adjustments. This leads to occasional errors which impact cash balances and FX effectiveness. Recently, a software update broke her macros, causing unexpected cash balances and ineffective FX hedges. This resulted in a large loss. Thomas shows Sarah his new liquidity management solution and explains how it automatically reads cash balance data, applies rules, and executes FX trades. He suggests Sarah speaks to their FX representative at Deutsche Bank to see if they can help with streamlining her hedging workflow. Sarah works with the FX team at Deutsche Bank to adapt her existing spreadsheet tool. They create a process that automatically reads balance sheet data, combines it with the cash balance information used for Thomas's solution, and generates FX hedge adjustments. Hedging small amounts would be inefficient, so Sarah applies thresholds for each currency based on the organization's risk tolerances. The new process is fully automated, from data aggregation to trade determination, execution, and reporting. It is also integrated with Thomas's existing workflow, and transaction dates are aligned. So FX hedges are automatically rolled to ensure they no longer negatively impact cash balances. Sarah has reduced the chance of errors and the need for manual adjustment. She no longer needs to worry about her macros breaking and finds she has more time to concentrate on other priorities. She has created a more detailed hedging solution than would be practical manually. It is better aligned to their underlying trading activity. This means operational risk and accounting noise is reduced, whilst transparency is maintained. As the solution is refined, Sarah and Thomas focus on how they can leverage automation to address future challenges. They realize it isn't an end state, but rather an exciting new process that gives their organization a competitive advantage.